Welcome to the Fit Mama Podcast, where it's all about gaining your health back as a busy woman and mom, and doing it without sacrificing time with your family or business. Here is your host, mompreneur and Fit Mama health coach, Angela Campbell.
All right, so let's rock and roll. So if you are listening, you're either listening to this later on the podcast or you're listening right now in the Facebook group, definitely say hi to our wonderful Alison. I can't wait for you guys to hear her story today. She's a busy mom. So today is Fit Mama's podcast, episode number 2. And so you're going to hear from this amazing woman, mom. She's also a busy, successful mompreneur, and how she took her life back. If you didn't see her transformation picture, and if you're not in my Fit Mompreneur group, we posted it in there and we'll post it everywhere as well too, but amazing transformation, not only in just weight loss, losing inches, but also just taking her life back. I think you're a beautiful example for other women. So I want other women to hear from you how she's lost, I believe you said, over 30 pounds, gained an amazing amount of confidence, which to me is huge. So on today's podcast, we're going to talk about it. She's going to share it all, but you're also going to learn how a day in the life of a busy mom and entrepreneur looks like. How it's possible to fit in time for you, how Alison lost her 30 plus pounds, gained her confidence, how it's affected her life, but also her business, which I think is very important for the women that are listening to this podcast or, of course, in the group. And then know also, if you're listening and you're watching, definitely, there's a lot of women commenting, saying hi, I love it. And so if you are a tired woman, a tired mom, and you feel like you've failed over and over and over trying to do this by yourself, and you're truly serious, definitely reach out. If you're in my Facebook group, there's a link above. Click it. Let's set up a free call just to chat about your options. Or if you're listening to this in the podcast, like I said, you can go to my website. It's www.acfitmama.com/chat. And let's talk. Because again, if you're in the group already and you have seen Allison's results, like, we see women all the time having amazing results. They're losing weight, shrinking belly fat, which I know is a common thing for us women want to get rid of. But they're finding ways to fit their health in while they're juggling everything. And I feel like that's so powerful, important for these women to hear. Because also, ladies that you're listening, if you're hearing Allison's story, I want you to also realize that if she can do it, if I can do it, if all these other women can do it, that means so can you, right? I mean, like, so can you do it. Right. So again, you're going to share her story, or she's going to share her story. You're going to hear it. and again, I want to start though, really quickly, giving some pretty amazing women some shout outs. And cause I feel very, very, proud of some amazing women we're working together and coaching, or they're taking products and all the things. So first, I want to do that. So I want to shout out to a few women. So hopefully if they're not watching now, hopefully they will be watching later. First shout out today that I want to share is Lori Alazaba. And hopefully you'll catch this later. But if not, I want to give her a major shout out because this woman is someone that I've known for years and she's taken her life back. And she's a busy woman. She gets up at like 2 a.m. in the morning. Like, it's insane with her work schedule. But she's on week 3. Excuse my cracky voice. She's on, you know, going into her week 3 of her new journey. She's already down 10 pounds, dropping inches, and feeling so much better in so many ways. So first shout out, Lori Alazaba. If you catch this later, phenomenal job. Give her some kudos in the comments if you are in the group. Give a shout out to Lori. The next shout out I want to give is Crystal Slater. Crystal, hi, I think I see you on. You said hi. So Crystal, you guys, I want to give her a big shout out because again, if you're in our Facebook group, like you've probably seen her sharing, she's doing phenomenal. She's already down 15 pounds, shrinking like crazy. Her transformation is amazing. And she's been doing this while juggling mom life, juggling work life, juggling a tragedy in her house and her home with her family and still trucking along, girl. So Crystal, if you're listening, phenomenal. I'm super proud of you. Super proud of you for that. So I want to give you some shout outs for that. So I know you guys are dying to hear from Alison. So let's dig into it. But if one last thing, if you are listening to this later in the podcast, you can find her inside our group, just acfitmama.com. There's a big old button on the front that says join our free community. Do that so you can see Allison's transformation among other women's as well too. So with that said, again, you guys, today's topic, I want you to hear from Alison. I want you to hear how this crazy busy mompreneur and the things that she's been doing, also like remodeling and building a home and doing a lot of things and still finding time to do this. So if you're ready, Alison, I know I would love to go into it. Start with you by just sharing who you are, maybe a little bit about your family. What is it that you do now for a job versus maybe what you did before as well?
Hey, everybody. Super excited to be here. Thank you, Angela, so much for asking me to be on this with you. So, yeah, I'm Alison Jackson. I live in a very small little town. You know, you wouldn't think that you would be successful like I have been in such a small town that I'm in. I'm a mom of three, and my two boys are only a year apart, so total craziness. Everybody always like used to warn us when they were babies, oh my gosh, you're gonna have your hands full, and we're like, shh, it's easy, like when they were babies, and then we're like, oh my gosh, they're right. and so I used to work in an automotive factory here in my hometown, and I was there for like almost 9 years. And first I started, you know, at the bottom working on the floor, you're running a machine, and then I got an office position. And when I got the office position, me and my better half found each other and we found out we was pregnant with baby number one. So I went on maternity leave. And then 3 months after I had our first son, I found out I was pregnant with baby number two. And so I went on another maternity leave only a year apart. And I had a big wake up call when I come off the second maternity leave. And that's really where my journey totally changed in my life and in my business. When I returned from my second maternity leave in a year's time, I was greeted at the door and they told me that I no longer had the position that I was in for 5 years prior. And they had moved my stuff. They had moved me to a total different department that I had no clue about. And for me, that was a wake up call that, you know, I could lose my job at any time, that I'm really basically just a number. When it comes to corporate America, you are totally replaceable to them. That's how they see it. And I was like, I need some change. And so I started back into network marketing. I actually first started in network marketing with my daughter. She is 12, almost going to be 13 before too long. Oh my gosh, going to have a teenager. And so I've kind of like been dabbling in the industry for about 13 years now. It's kind of insane to say that. This seems like I'm really old. But I guess I started when I was really young and Facebook wasn't a big thing. Like I had like dial up internet, like you know, a lot has changed in the industry. So anyways, when I got the news that they had, you know, moved me to a different position, it was a very depressing moment. Any mamas here, you feel me when you're going back to work and you're already leaving your infant and you're super emotional because you're leaving your infant. And usually you're leaving your infant in the hands of someone else. And like, it is already an emotional day. And then to be greeted at the door just made it that much more emotional. With no warning, no signs, no nothing. It was kind of just like a big hit to me. And it really started to affect me. And I really started getting depressed. And then with depression come a lot of weight gain and just not liking where I was. Like, I wasn't liking where I was in my life. I wasn't liking where I was in, you know, making money. But I felt stuck, right? We all get to that where we feel like we're stuck. Like, we have to do this job. We have to show up every day. Like, we need that check. We need that insurance on our kids. And that was where I was. I was like, oh my gosh, like, I'm not happy, but like, I have to have this job and I have to have the insurance for my kids. And, but I knew I needed to do something because I was not happy where I was. You know, I was around a lot of toxic people. The environment was toxic and it affected me mentally. And when I come home, I was completely drained. I had nothing left to give to my family. I mean, I was at the lowest I'd ever been. And I was at the heaviest, even when I was pregnant, 9 months pregnant with all three of my kids, I had never weighed that much in my life. So I seen this business and, I was introduced to it. I was shown a very quick video and I watched that video like, I don't know how many times. Yeah. And I was like blown away. Like, I couldn't believe it. Like when I watched the video, I was like, this is not real. Right. Like this, I don't know, you know, 'cause I've been in the industry and I was really skeptical and I was really skeptical about the products because, you know, like me and my better half, me and Eric would try to do like these diets and we would have success with the diets for a short period of time. And then it was like too stressful to count things, write things down, do all this stuff. And so we would stop and then we gain weight back. So that was where I was at, you know, excuse me. So I had tried several different products before. And no success. I had stared at the Walmart shelf with the magic tablet saying it was going to shrink me down. And I was like, okay, if that one's in a lockbox, it must be pretty good. Right. So like, I'm going to give it a try. So I've been there, I've tried a ton of stuff. And so when this come in, I was still a little bit skeptical, but I had seen a lot. I was added to a community where I got to see a lot of testimonies of people having great success using the products. And I was like, I'm going to do this. And I jumped all in. I jumped into the business and I jumped into the products all at the same time. And I've had amazing success, you know, using the products. I started losing weight in inches. And there was no dramatic change to my diet. And I wasn't hustling it out in the gym. So for me, I was like, oh my gosh, this fits, you know, into my life. And I was, like I said, I was working a full-time job. And so as far as the business part, I was just waking up a little bit earlier and doing my post before I went to work. And then like on my lunch break, I would do some work, listen to stuff and, you know, just fit it into the nooks and crannies. And then at nighttime, like I just loved it so much. Like, it was so amazing. It's so much different than what I had ever experienced in business before because it was attraction marketing instead of like the icky spamming and feeling like a bad person. And so like it was really super simple because it was just people were coming to me. They wanted to know more about what I was doing. And so I was finding such enjoyment. I would stay up a little bit later at night, you know, and Eric, he'd be like, are you going to bed? I'm like, oh, like I'm on a roll. Like, you know, I got all these people, you know, and I was just so excited. And so as I did that, you know, just fit it into the nooks and crannies, about 3-4 months into the business, I was able to leave my full-time job and come home. And I've been home with my kids ever since. And like Angela said, I do kind of lead a little bit of a busy lifestyle. We have a new piece of property we've been working on and I have chickens. You can see my little chicken coop back here. So I chase chickens all the time. And, you know, I'm gardening now. So I've got a garden of my own where I'm growing, you know, our own food. And, then I'm chasing after kids, which right now is totally peaceful. Thank goodness to mammals and papaws because I have a moment of silence, right? So I'm really getting to enjoy some peace right now. But I'm super busy during my day, but I get to work my business on my time. And that's one thing I love. And the products are so simple. I mean, it's a tablespoon in the morning. It's a tablet with every meal that it's not consuming or stressing me out. And it's just really easy to fit into any lifestyle, you know?
Yeah. And I think that's very important that you say that too, because it, you know, you can get healthy with changing a few things in your lifestyle or fitting things into your lifestyle. A lot of people and women that I speak to, especially that have a schedule like yours, you have kids to take care of, you have a house to take care of, you have a business to run online, you have all the things to do and other people to help on their journeys, sharing the products and stuff. So it can be to totally go into a crazy strict diet that turns your world upside down isn't realistic for people with our lifestyles. And so I love that you said that because it's fitting it into your lifestyle, whether it be product, whether it be nutrition, whether it be the fitness side. And even if you don't necessarily go to the gym, like Would you say you're so much more active now than you were when you had those extra pounds on and you weren't a happy person on the inside?
Yeah. So that's a big thing for me. As a mom, when I talk to moms, they're like, you know, sometimes I'll have moms and they're looking at joining me and looking at the products and they're like, I usually don't ever spend that much on myself. And so this is what I always tell my mamas, like, there, you cannot put a price on the moments and the memories that I have gained back because I lost the weight. Because there was a time that I just wanted to lay on the couch. I'm not kidding. And it's okay. Like, you have to admit it to yourself that I was in that position. You know, I love to cook and I had totally stopped wanting to go to the kitchen and cook because cooking then evolved to cleaning and washing dishes. And I was just not there physically and I was not there mentally and I just didn't feel like doing it. And actually, you know, I was looking at, we have a big, huge swimming pool at our place that we live at. And I was looking at it today, or I was looking at it yesterday, actually. And I noticed that, you know, like, I haven't cleaned the pool. I haven't been in the pool. And it's probably been like that for 3 years now. It's not been touched. And when me and Eric first got together and after our sons, right after each pregnancy, like, I was dying to get in that pool. Like, I was, you know, he'd be like, well, if you're going to, you know, if you'll clean it, you know, I'll help you pump it out and, you know, you can scrub it down and then we'll fill it back up. And I was like, yeah, like, I love this swimming pool. But for 3 years until now, I had not done anything with the swimming pool. So when you think about it, when you're investing into yourself and you're investing into your health and you're wanting to make a change, it's not just you being selfish. Like, so many of us think that it's being selfish, that it's just we're putting ourselves before our family. But what we're realizing is when we put ourselves on the back burner, we're actually not giving our best selves to our kids, to our family. You know, like, I would not have the flowers in my flower bed this year if I had not lost the weight. I would not have a garden this year if I had not lost the weight. I would not be, you know, chasing my kids around if I hadn't lost the weight. You know, I wouldn't be like begging to get another swimming pool if I hadn't lost the weight, because those were all things that I just didn't have the energy for. And I didn't feel I wanted, you know, like, I wasn't in that mental state of being in those moments with my kid. And I tell a lot of people, okay, you can go to the beach with your kids. And when you're like me, when you're overweight and you go to the beach, you watch your kids play in the water and they're having an absolute blast. Don't get me wrong. They are playing and having a freaking blast, but you're not there with them. Most of us are sitting on the sidelines and we are not even in the moment because we're consumed with the worry of our leg showing or our arm showing, or, you know, it's hot and we're sweating and we don't feel good because we're overweight. And so we're not enjoying that moment with our kids. And I want you all to ask yourselves as parents, as a mom, I asked myself this a while back. You know, I grew up, my mom was overweight a lot of my life and she missed out on a lot of things. So now I'm like, I don't want to miss out on a lot of things. And my mom absolutely loved me. Like, you know, it's not, we don't mean to do that to our kids or for them to miss out on us. But when our kids get older, as I am now, I look back and I'm like, my mom didn't take those hikes with us. My dad did. When we would go camping, my dad would, and my mom would sit back. You know, my dad would go swimming with us, but my mom would sit back. You know, and we can lay out all the excuses of, well, I'm just too old to get in that swimming suit and get in that swimming pool. But in reality, it's because we don't feel comfortable. We're not proud of what our body is, or, you know, how we feel. And so we don't go swimming. My dad is in his 50s now, and he'll still go swimming with my kids. My mom, she's still on, like, I just got her on products not that long ago. And so we're working on that, you know. But I remember growing up, those were the moments my mom missed out on. And so as I started gaining weight and I started getting heavy, and then I started seeing myself missing those moments, and then I started thinking, like, I can give my kids all the toys in the world. I can spoil them to death. I can give them all the TV and electronics. But when they get older and become my age, they're going to value the time that I spent with them and I was in those moments with them more than they are that video game that I gave them when they were 10 years old. You know, and so that's how it's so important for us to feel good and be physically able to be active with them. So that's usually what I tell mamas.
Well, and I mic drop, if I could drop it right now, that would be like the moment, because I feel like everything you just said, you probably hit all the moms listening or the moms that are going to listen to this later on the podcast in the heartstrings, because it's the number one conversation I have with a lot of women that are looking for help, because that's exactly, I can't tell you how many that have talked to me and they're sitting in the chair at the beach while their husband is out there playing with the kids, because they're not either confident in who they are, they don't love who they are, maybe they're a little bit overweight, you know. But the thing with the weight loss, which I think has really helped yourself and a lot of people, is like, come when the weight loss comes, the confidence rises again too. And the thing, another thing that I see a lot is not only just the memories of physically being there, that your kids are going to remember you playing on the beach with them, or you know, doing whatever it is that you guys love to do. It's the pictures too. Like, I know so many moms that hide from the camera. My mom's one of them too. Like, we go looking back and I'm like, Mom, I don't have any pictures with you. Like, what is the problem here? I want pictures, and I want my kids maybe to have thousands of pictures. But I know a lot of moms that hide from that camera for the same reason. And it's the same, like, later on down the road when you know, there's going to be a day where we're not here anymore. We want them to have those memories, even in pictures, to carry on and show, you know, or to remember you by, at least. And so you hit the nail on the head, like, investing in yourself, and whether it be money to get product or to get coaching, or maybe it's just time. Like, it's all so important, because if you are not, as a woman and a mom, taking care of yourself, we're actually harming our family than we are, I feel like, doing any good. Like, it's imperative for us to put ourselves first so that we can be better for them. And I think that's a thing that moms struggle with really bad. That whole big thing, yeah. Moms, we talked about that a lot in last week's podcast. We don't want to do it. So if you're listening and you're in the group right now, put mom guilt below if you suffer from it, because we're all in that same boat, I think. Yeah. But you said exactly, like, but if we don't invest time or even money, like, we're not doing our family a service. We're just giving them whatever's left over. And that's, I know no mom is going to say that that's all they want to give their family. You know what I mean? So yeah. Now, one question I would love for you to share too is the journey, like, getting the weight off. Explain or share, like, I know you said you weren't really big on the measurements and all that stuff. But as far as time frame, like, it didn't happen overnight, right? Like, no. It takes time to get unhealthy. So what would you say as far as your journey, as far as, like, how it took? And you've been maintaining it like crazy and keeping it off for a while now, correct?
Yep. So I started the products probably back, I think about a year and 6 months now, pretty close to that. And you know, and like, life gets in, you know, life gets busy. Okay. Like, my mom found out she had cancer. And so, like, I was in the hospital with my mom for a while. So we all have, like, those moments where slip ups happen, you know, like, you're in the hospital and you're staying, you know, away from your home. And so I did, I had those moments where, like, I slipped and I wasn't consistent with the products. But then, you know, like, I got back on them. Like, I didn't just, like, say, oh, well, I slipped up and, you know, now it's too late. No, like, and what was great that I love is, you know, on this program, when you're using the products and you're making the simple changes and you're not going extreme, the moment that you have that you slip up, you know, like the moment that I had where I needed to be with my mom, you know, it didn't make me, like, gain all that weight back, you know, like, that fast, you know, and that's what I had experienced in all the previous bad things that I had done was, you know, as soon as I quit, like, the pounds were, like, right back on my butt like soon.
Yeah.
So that was one thing. Yeah. So that was one thing that I enjoyed is, you know, I had that moment with my mom and I was able to not stress out about it. And, you know, being in the hospital, you got hospital food. I mean, that's just the reality of it. But, you know, I was able to make simple changes, even in that sense, even in that moment, you know, like instead of getting that pop, go get water. Instead of getting like the deep fried bowl of grease, you know, chicken, I got the grilled chicken. You know, for me, it was just making the simple choices. You know, my kids like McDonald's. Well, that's fine. Let's go to McDonald's. But instead of me ordering those French fries, I'm just not going to order them. And I'm going to order a grilled chicken instead of the chicken nuggets, you know, and maybe you just eat half the bun instead of the whole bun, you know, like just the simple things. Like I always tell my clients, like, don't stress yourself out. Like, it's just simple changes. Just try to drink more water than what you normally used to drink, you know, try to not drink pop. It's been a long time since I had a pop. Well, maybe the other day I had a pop, but you know, like I used to be a really fanatic pop drinker, you know, and I've just made the simple choice of, okay, I can enjoy a pop every now and then, but I'm going to drink more water. You know, and just not eating fried foods, doing my best. But I, you know, if there's moments that I eat a French fry, I'm not going to like, oh my gosh, you know. And that's what I love is the supplements that I include into my simple lifestyle change has still gotten me amazing results. You know, I went down 46 pounds and I'll tell you, don't focus on the scale. Okay. A lot of people ask me how much weight I've lost and I really kind of like cringe. I'm like, I don't want you to focus on the pounds. Okay. Because I'm going to share with you this picture here because the pounds don't matter. Oh, I got a glare. The pounds don't matter. When I see this picture, I don't care what that scale says. I mean, would you care what the scale says if you've seen these results? Oh gosh, it clicked off of it. Yeah. I mean, somebody messaged me. But I mean, if you've seen those results, does it matter what the scale says? You know, and so taking the before pictures was a big key to my success.
Yes.
Because if I would have just focused on the scale, honestly, I would have got discouraged within the first month. But I had pictures from where I started. And then like, I took another picture, you know, a month in and I could put them side by side. And I was like, oh my gosh, you can tell a difference in the inches. Like you can tell that my belly is flattening out. Like it's working, you know, but if I would have just focused on the scale, I would have totally, you know, given myself a hard time and wanted to quit within a month because I wasn't seeing like, oh, you know, fabulous, you know, in a month losing tons of weight because that doesn't happen. Okay. Reality is it takes time and staying consistent. The first picture that I showed you all, this is like a little over 5 months, I believe 5 months of staying consistent, huge change. And, you know, I don't care what the scale says because the scale can always fluctuate, you know?
Yeah.
You know, and I always try to share this story because I actually had a friend of mine. She's starting to use the products and I like to share her story because she wanted to focus on the scale. And like her first full month of staying consistent, maybe a little bit longer than a month, she sent me a message and she was like, oh my gosh, is there something like, am I doing something wrong or is this not working for me? Like the scale says I've gained 15 pounds. And I'm like, girl, like, okay, just calm down first. And she's like, I'm really trying to listen to you and not focus on the scale. And I'm like, okay, it's all right. Like, well, you know, and what I love about our, you know, our business that we do is that I have people like Angela and I have people, you know, on my team and I can reach out and have more help. Yeah. And so I put her in a group chat and we chatted with her and my sideline sisters were like, hey, did you do any measurements? And she's like, you know what? I actually did, but I have not checked them yet. So she went home that night and she checked her measurements. Okay. This woman had already told me, she's like, I've gained 15 pounds. Like what's going on?
Yeah.
And she went and checked her measurements and she had lost 4.5 inches, 4.5 inches. Okay. That's, it's working. It's changing your body. you know, in that first month, your body is kind of freaking out when you start on the supplements, right? Because your body is not storing fat like it used to. So it's like, oh my gosh, like I got to hold this spot where this fat used to be. So it fills it with water because it doesn't want to let go. Like it thinks you're going to give it some fat, and using the products, you're not. So, you know, and so it stores all that water. And that's why I told her, I was like, you know, like, when's the last time you did a detox? And she's like, well, she didn't really enjoy them. And I'm like, well, I got one at the house, so come up and get it and use it. And then just a few days later, she had already dropped down like 6.5 pounds. But it was because her body was, you know, trying to keep that spot where her fat used to be, because, you know, but as you give it time and as you stick with it, your results are going to get crazy amazing. And that's where I'm at in my journey. And the pictures are what kept me going, you know, having those pictures and comparing really kept me focused.
Absolutely. And that was going to be a question I was going to ask you, which I think you just already answered it. The biggest advice for any woman out there is take the pictures. I know the women that I do that we're working one-on-one together in my coaching too, is that it's pictures every 2 weeks. So we check them. Cause that scale can be the biggest fat liar ever. And it happens all the time. And some people don't see that change on the scale for a while, or maybe even it goes up a little bit first and then the inches are coming. Cause that's the same approach. I mean, some of the women in my coaching are obviously taking products, but not all of them, but we're doing those small minor tweaks, like you mentioned, with the lifestyle changes, working it around your current life, instead of just like going this crazy strict diet where you lose weight super fast and then you end up quitting because it's too hard, and then you give up and then you gain it all back and then some. That's just like a common thing in today's world, in our society. There's so many things out there. So I think it's very important finding the small changes and being patient with yourself and staying surrounded by amazing people like yourself and the other women in my Fit Mompreneur group. Like, they're constantly lifting each other up, reminding themselves, it's okay. I promise it's coming. Stick with it. It will be worth it in the long run. It takes time. So yeah, if you're listening to the podcast or you're live right now with us in the group or watching this even on a replay later, like, biggest piece of advice, you heard it from Alison: be patient, take time, stop chasing the quick fix. The quick fix is not, if you ever come to me for help and that's all you want is I want now, I'm probably going to send you somewhere else, because it's not what I believe in. It's not what it works for the long term, so that you can be that healthier version of you, so that you can create those memories with your family. And that's golden. That is so very important. So, oh my gosh, you've dropped so many amazing golden nuggets today, Alison, and shared your amazing story. And if you're listening or you're not in our Facebook group, again, you can go to, if you're in our Facebook group, in a second when I hop off here, I'll drop some of her transformation pictures in the comments of this podcast too. Or again, if you're listening to it on the podcast, go to www.acfitmama.com, and the big old fat button on the front page, it says join the group, and get in there and see them. And I'm sure she'd be happy to answer questions if you reach out to her as well. And again, Alison, I couldn't thank you enough for coming on today. I know you said so many things that other women and moms need to hear from another woman that has been there, done that, and is doing the do, and now helping other women do the same thing. So yeah, I'm super excited. Thank you again for hopping on. Ladies, again, if you're in the group and you're listening, drop questions. You can drop questions under in the comments as well. She'll answer them, or we'll get someone to answer them. There's people saying, commenting, Sheila said, you're amazing, Alison. Crystal said, amen, love pictures. Yes, Crystal Slater is on here. She's one of the ones down 15 pounds, but her pictures are worth 1,000 words. Mm-hmm. She's on here as well too. So again, thank you. Anybody that's listening, again, get in the group, go check it out. If you're struggling on the struggle bus right now, reach out and ask for help. Reach out. Like, some of the biggest things I know for me personally, not only in business, but in life and in my health, is sideline sisters. You said sideline sisters while ago talking in our business. It's, to me, it's priceless to know that you have other women that are on that same or similar journey with you, that you can lean on, so that they can pick you up on that day that you're having a bad day and want to quit because the scale's not moving. or you're just straight up tired and you don't want to get up and get your body moving. So that's the community as well in the Fit Mompreneur community, how the women are in there too. So again, if you're struggling, you need help, let's talk. We'll talk. We can help you figure out a way to get yourself started. You can set up a free chat with me as well, just where we will talk one-on-one. And the link above, if you're in the group, or just go to, again, my website, acfitmama.com/chat. We'll figure out a time to work with us and or to chat about it, figure out what works best for you. And again, thank you all, everybody that's tuning in today. Thank you again for Alison. Give her some love in the comments for sure if you're in the group. This will also be uploaded on the podcast here in the next few days so you guys can re-listen. And again, that's it. Thank you so much, Alison, for your time.
Enjoy. Thanks for having me. I really appreciate it, you know, and I just hope it, some moms just need that moment of like, okay, that realization, you know, seeing that I need to invest in, you know, like this is a good thing. It's not a bad thing. We might think it's selfish, but it's not. So I really appreciate you all having me here. Thank you so much for listening. And yeah, thanks. Thank you again. I'm honored that you asked.
Of course. Thank you very much. I'm so excited.